In today's video, I want to take a look at PlayStation possibly looking to acquire more studios beyond their acquisition of Insomniac. If you guys are unaware, Sony and Insomniac were working together on a variety of different titles from Ratchet & Clank, Marvel, Spider-Man, but now Sony has officially acquired Insomniac into the foray of their first-party studios. Looks like they will be looking to acquire more studios. We'll talk all about that. Also, Ubisoft is planning to add crossplay to all of its PvP games in the future, and future titles are to feature stronger identity for themselves. Dauntless Haunted Shadows free update launches today on the PlayStation 4. We'll cover that at the end of this video. And before we get into everything, I just want to remind you guys to make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit the bell notification icon so you're always notified of uploads. And that definitely helps out the channel too, so we always appreciate that. But first up, let's take a look at PlayStation looking to acquire more studios, because this is something very interesting to talk about. While Sony is always heralded for having the best first-party video games, possibly in gaming, I see some people want to make the argument towards Nintendo as well, and definitely an apt argument to be had. I personally think, bias aside, that Sony does have the stronger offerings, but let's not get into that debate right now. What is interesting is it's not like Sony has this abundance of first-party studios. That's not the case at all. It's just that every single one of their first-party studios is clearly defined and they have their own objective, and they usually deliver quality game after quality game, and there's an incredible level of consistency. You've got Naughty Dog, you've got Insomniac now, you've got Sucker Punch. Sony Santa Monica is obviously in there, and they've got a couple of other studios, but it's not like they have this roster of 20, 25 studios developing games. That's not the case at all. It's just their games turn out really, really good, even though you only get usually two major exclusives a year, and then you'll get it rounded out with some smaller exclusives. This year, it was really highlighted by Days Gone and Death Stranding, and then you had smaller exclusives like Concrete Genie, Medieval Remake, rounding things out. But it's not like they have this enormous roster of first-party studios. However, they are looking to grow. PlayStation Worldwide Studios currently consists of 14 development studios around the world. Hiroki Totoki, senior EVP and CFO of PlayStation, made it sound like those teams might be adding more family members very soon, noting at the investor relation day in May, he said, quote, "We mentioned that Sony's strength lies in our first party content and IP," and he went on to say that going forward, they will continue to pursue growth investment opportunities that will enhance our own content IPs. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that they are hunting for new studios. However, I think it's imperative that they do as such, because Microsoft is in acquisition mode. Getting Ninja Theory, Obsidian, they have gotten some major studios, and this is why I'm so excited going into next generation, because yes, Sony is always going to be delivering quality first-party titles. However, there was really nothing to compete with. You look at Microsoft's first-party offerings, and they are abysmal compared to Sony. I do not believe that is going to be the case next generation, with Playground doing an open-world RPG, more Halo coming, Coalition's probably going to do more Gears, and that's fine. Those two franchises can be your helm, but they are going to be making new IPs as well, with Ninja Theory, Obsidian, and all of these other studios that they are acquiring. Compelling games are coming for Microsoft and Xbox. Some of you guys want to always crap over Xbox and Microsoft, and rightfully so. This generation, you know, Phil Spencer had to do a lot of damage control and rebuilding, and he rebuilt Xbox Game Studios, so they have a roster of talented studios creating Xbox exclusives, although they will be on PC as well. But now Sony has some direct competition. Nintendo is always out there, but the thing about Nintendo is the majority of people don't buy the Nintendo Switch or any Nintendo platform as a primary gaming platform. What usually happens is it's a secondary platform to complement your Xbox One or your PlayStation 4 or whatever the next generation platforms are gonna be. Those platforms, the Microsoft and Sony platforms, they are always head-to-head competition. If you really look at it, it's always been Sony versus Microsoft, PlayStation 3 versus Xbox 360, PlayStation 4 versus Xbox One. You never really see like Wii U versus PlayStation 3 arguments or anything like that. You don't really even see PlayStation 4 versus Switch, because usually people will get a Nintendo platform as a complementary platform to one of the aforementioned platforms. I think that is an accurate assessment of how the consoles work. Obviously, there are people that just get a Nintendo Switch and are completely happy with it, but generally speaking, it's usually you get a PlayStation 4, Xbox One, or maybe you have a gaming PC, and then you'll get a Nintendo Switch to round out your gaming offerings. That's just what I've noticed, and for PlayStation, it is going to be important that they acquire more studios, because they cannot rest on their laurels. I am telling you guys, if come 2020, 2021, it becomes a year where Microsoft is dropping the next Halo, the next Fable, and a bunch of other exclusives, and Sony only has Horizon and a Demon's Souls remake, I mean, that is incredibly compelling in its own right, but the competition is gonna be steep. It's not gonna be like this generation where it was pretty much a landslide victory for PlayStation 4. Sony, honestly, they didn't even have to do as much as they did. They could have reeled back and not released as many exclusives because there was no competition. There were years, literal years that went by where Xbox One did not get a single compelling exclusive in the sense that it was a marquee, well-received exclusive. There were years that went by that Xbox One did not get one. I'm talking about like singular years. Usually you'll get at least one big exclusive every year or two. And what the problem with Xbox really was the fact that they kept relying on Forza, Halo, Gears, and they kept going back to the well on that. They never got a lot of compelling titles. Sunset Overdrive was cool, Quantum Break was cool, but they never transcended into that next class of being masterclass games. Hopefully with the next generation, Sony has a bunch of those titles, Microsoft has a bunch of those titles, and you know what they say, iron sharpens iron, and hopefully they'll both elevate each other. That's what I'm hoping for at least. Alright, so enough rambling on that. Ubisoft is planning to add crossplay to all of its PvP games, future titles to feature stronger identity as well. Ubisoft players can look forward to being able to crossplay across platforms in the future, according to what CEO Yves Guillemot said during yesterday's fiscal year 2020 half-year earnings call. He noted, quote, "Yes, our goal is to put crossplay on all the PvP games that we have over time, so that's really underway." Followed up with, "And while I say early to draw any conclusion, we believe it will contribute to continuing increasing engagement, but it's too early to do a final conclusion. We've been very happy with the very strong growth of Brawlhalla again in Q2, that's what we can say at this stage." Later in the earnings call, Guillemot had to discuss how the company intends to avoid the issues caused by Ghost Recon Breakpoint and that game's lukewarm reception. "The first order of business will be to ensure each game is well differentiated and comes with its own strong identity." Noting, quote, "First of all, making sure that each breakthrough, new formula, change in formula, new brands are coming with very highly optimized experiences, and that our key goal that we're stating very clearly, loud and clear, and that's why we believe that these three games that are coming within a very strong promise, a strong element of differentiation, will be very well delivered. And also, in general, what we said is we'll spend more time and have an additional pillar in our quality approach into building differentiation elements to improve the marketability of our games." So Ubisoft is looking to add cross-platform play to all of its PvP titles, and it looks like they do want to deliver more experiences that are identifiable from one another. A lot of the Ubisoft games do kind of blend together at times. I think creating distinct experiences and all of them being compelling new IPs, I think that is something that is a good strategy going forward, especially after the lukewarm reception of some of their titles this year. I dug The Division 2, but commercially that game didn't do all too well, and Ghost Recon Breakpoint was kind of a train wreck. So let's see if they can get back on track into 2020 and honestly into 2021. This is something that's going to parlay well into next generation. And lastly, I do want to talk a little bit about Dauntless's Haunted Shadows free update that has dropped today on the PlayStation 4. Dauntless was a free-to-play title that I covered quite a bit on this channel, and it's quite a good title, even though most of you guys have moved back to Monster Hunter World with Monster Hunter World Iceborne. However, now we have Dauntless's latest free update in Haunted Shadows. It's a free update once again, and they noted, "We're always listening closely to community feedback, and we're happy to share that Haunted Shadows brings within numerous performance and quality of life improvements. Starting today, we're introducing an AFK timer to all hunts, so slayers who go idle for more than 3 minutes will be automatically returned to Ramsgate. As always, Behemoth health and difficulty will automatically scale for the remaining party. We've also done a full design pass on our compass system, ensuring that slayers can easily find their way around Ramsgate, identify quest prompts, and track flares while on a hunt." There are dozens of more nuanced changes that arrive with Haunted Shadows, so if you're interested in digging in, go check out our official community page over on Reddit. Lastly, they wanted to remind all PlayStation Plus subscribers about the exclusive Royal Steel weapon skin set. You can grab it now at the PlayStation Store and look especially regal as you slay some monsters. Dauntless is a pretty good game, and it's been getting consistent free updates. If you don't want to invest the money into Monster Hunter World or you want to try something a little bit different, Dauntless does offer its own unique elements, and with the Haunted Shadows update, the game is just getting better, and it looks like they're going to remain committed into making the game better and better, so that's always good. And that's going to conclude this video. Again, PlayStation may be looking to acquire more studios beyond Insomniac. Ubisoft is planning to add crossplay to all of its PvP games. Future titles are going to be featuring stronger identity, and Dauntless's Haunted Shadows free update drops today on the PlayStation 4. That's going to conclude this video. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching.